I'm Charlie Jordan, and I'm going to talk about the Metallak / Nirvana Hotel, the hotel that never was. Colebrook was kind of late getting onto the bandwagon of the resorts that were, you know, we're just on the upper edge of the White Mountains here, and there were so many hotels that were flourishing in the late 19th century in the White Mountains to the south of us. We have two mountains that overlook Colebrook. And one of them we think is ours, but we really know it's not really ours. It's Vermont's. It's the other Monadnock. You know, there's the one in Keene. Well, this is the one in Vermont, but it looms over Colebrook. Well, the other facing that is Lombard Hill, which is just, that is in Colebrook, okay? And so these entrepreneurs looked at this hillside and said, what a great place to build a hotel, right up on the top of this. So this is like the early 1890s. So they start making this plan for this really multi-room facility up there with turrets and everything, and they came up with this fabulous sketch of what this was going to look like. And at that point, a name is still is today, Metallak, the Indian chief, is kind of a legend in this whole region. He was the last of his tribe and actually died a blind pauper, but his legend grew. You hear all kinds of stories about where he was. At that point, he had been dead for probably 40 years, so they figured, okay, no problems with copyrights. We'll just take his name, you know, and call this the Metallak Hotel. So there were like hotel publications on the East Coast that were announcing this big hotel that was planned for Colebrook. So then they got this great idea. Somebody said, right across that other mountain across the Connecticut, Monadnock has this great mineral springs. And if we can promote it as a mineral springs house, it'll bring in people from all over, and Colebrook will be brought into the great summer resort, you know, industry. The problem was that the springs had a native curse on it, an Indian curse, supposedly. And the curse was that you were not supposed to use this for commercial gain, okay? So they said, what the heck, we'll just bottle it and sell it, and it'll be on the tables of all of our guests. As they started to move forward, it was like one delay after another. This incredible building, they kept having mudslides up there, and then it was a terrible winter. The winter of 1892, 1893 was just horrendous. And so the crews had to keep coming down, bring things back up. Again, this is pre-automobile, pre-trucks. Everything had to be brought up by horses and carriages. And so somebody started to say, you know, maybe it's this thing about the Indian curse. Maybe, you know, let's change the name. You know, just because it started to get rumored around. So they said, let's come up with another name. So they went to like another whole different realm. They came up with the name Nirvana, a nice Buddhist name. This is peace, everything, this thing's gonna be calm. Things only got worse. You know, that spring, there were like torrential rains, and every time they'd bring equipment up there, it would just slide back down the hill. One night, this incredible, what they called a gale, blew through, and it just blew the whole house of cards down. Just came right down. And at that point, it was like, this is it. We just aren't going to build this hotel. And they actually collected the wood, and that hotel is built somewhere in Maine. They took all their money and everything, and what they left was a foundation. And that foundation is still there to this day. But so we look at that as the hotel that never was. But an interesting thing was nobody ever really saw a picture of the place. Nobody had taken a photograph, they thought. And then about 10 years ago, a picture actually came up on eBay, and two local history buffs were battling it out. Neither one of them lived in Colebrook anymore, but they had deep roots in Colebrook, and they were battling it out for this thing. And finally, this one fellow got it over the other fellow. And they told us about it. That was front page news in our paper. You know, here it is, the only known photograph, and it was taken just before the wind blew it down. You can see the construction was very near the end, but you also can see how that could happen. It was like, you know, on this high hillside, and it was just a target for some winds to blow through. So, but it was a hotel that never was here in Colebrook. Yeah.